Hi, I'm Stu Steinberg. In the more than 22 years I've been working in personal finance, I've seen my share of mistakes. Here, I've made a list of some 5 common errors that I warn my clients not to make. Number 1, budget. Every business needs one, no matter what size the business. The budget represents boundaries and ensures that money, it'll be available when you need it. I tell my clients to make a 1-year plan, even 3 and 5 and longer. I tell them that a budget should be respected, but it does not have to be etched in stone. Number 2, seek competent advice. Find a trusted advisor, a mentor, a friend, someone that you trust, someone that knows what they're talking about, especially when it comes to your business and your unique strategy. Don't trust yourself to know all the answers. None of us does. The best minds in the business are the ones that stay coachable. I just always say choose the right coaches. Choose wisely. Number 3, time management. A small business owner wears many hats. You might be the head honcho, head of marketing, technology director, social media guru, and chief window cleaner. I certainly am. Then there's research, design plans, and the sage advice you dole out along the way. Balance this with the demands of your personal life and tell me what it's like to feel your head spin like a frisbee. A weekly schedule can be the answer. It gives you structure, a game plan, a reference, and this is empowering. When you're on schedule, it shows others that, you know, you have integrity, and the world responds differently to the few who are self-directed. Number 4, file on time. Depending on your circumstances, you could be filing annually, quarterly, or monthly statements with the IRS. You may even have to file more. Whatever the case, do it on time. Try never to fall behind in payments, or with the tax returns, or any government for that matter. Hey, I'm not trying to scare you, it's just that staying off the IRS's naughty list will save you tons of headaches. And number 5, don't overdo it. Avoid spreading yourself so thin that you can't provide the service that you really want. When necessary, bring a qualified specialist to help you reach your goals. When your business starts growing, remember to take a step back and take into account what you need to continue that growth. Consider investing profits in personnel who can help you grow your business even more. Give yourself the best possible chance to succeed and put these strategies in place, and feel free to ask me for any other strategies.